Hi guys, it's Mary Brennan here, and I'm bringing you another short seated sequence for you to use at your home. Again, modify to make it comfortable for you. Check with your doctor first, of course, and then do it in a chair, couch. You can even do it in the morning in your bed. So a lot of my clients have been asking for poses for shoulders and upper backs, so we can hold a lot of tension there. I know with my MS, I had a lot of tension in my upper back when I first was diagnosed over 10 years ago. But through the yoga poses, it's really helped me. I would love to tell you that yoga has cured my MS, but that's just not the case. But it has helped a lot. So I offer this to you, and so let's start. So find a comfortable seat, either on the floor or a chair. Again, roll your shoulders up to your ears. As you exhale, roll them back and down. Let your chin tuck into your neck. Feel a nice stretch here. And just get grounded into this moment. So you may have had a busy morning, busy day, whatever time you're coming to watch this video. Just really feel yourself releasing whatever came before this, whatever will come after this, coming into the here, the now, letting go of all expectations, coming into self-love, self-kindness, self-acceptance. Take a deep breath in through your nose, a big sigh out through your mouth. Just let it all go. Two more times like that. In through your nose, out through your mouth. One more time, in through your nose, out through your mouth. Don't you feel better already? So from here, just reach your hands up. Feel your palms reaching up, shoulder blades come together. Then plant one palm into the floor, the earth, the cushion. Reach the other hand up, and then take your fingers over to that other side of your head, and then gently just sweep that bottom hand back into your hips, back into your body, and then just gently bringing the ear to your shoulder so that it's not like we're pushing or forcing anything. It's just a gentle guidance. And then feel a stretch from that ear to your shoulder, even to your fingertips. Take a breath in and a breath out. Breath in, breath out. One more breath in. Another breath out, and then release your hand. Let your fingers float down to the ground. Roll your shoulders up and then back, and then sweep the other hand over. And then just feel that stretch. And then when you're ready, that hand's gonna come over to your ear, and then gently sweeping that other ear to the shoulder, bringing that hand that's on the floor into your body. Oh, so this feels really good in the morning. At night, it feels good anytime actually. So whenever you have a few minutes, just feel this. You could do this at your desk, at work, anywhere. Breathe in, breathe out, and slowly release. Again, bring both of your hands down. Roll your shoulders up to your ears as you exhale. Roll them back and down. Inhale, sweep your arms up to the sides. And then when you're ready, sweep your hands in. Give yourself a big hug. Just keep a notice on what arm is in top. And then when you're ready, from here, just the arm that's on top, you're going to give a hug. It's going to release from your shoulders and it's going to sweep over to the other side of the room. And you're just going to hug it. And then with your fingertips, just rub your shoulder if there's any soreness there. If you feel any sensations, you can close your eyes. That'll connect you more to your sensations. Breathe in and breathe out here. Notice your shoulder blades. Drop your shoulders away from your ears. And then release that hand that's on the shoulder. Bring your arms to center, still crossed. Then take your hands and wrap them around. Now, if this is like something that's not gonna happen today, no worries. Just place the opposite hands on the opposite shoulders and just be here. So your elbows are in line with your shoulders and feel that stretch in your shoulder blades. They're really gliding away from your spine. It's a nice stretch. So either here, any modifications that are right for you. And then from here, we're going to slide our hands back. Our elbows are going to slide. So it's almost like we're in genie pose. So make three wishes here. And then from here, reach your arms up over your head. Now, whatever hand's in the back, let those fingers float behind, giving you support of that neck. And then the upper hand is just going to rest on the elbow. Take a deep breath in here, a slow breath out, and feel a nice stretch. Again, no sharp pains, only nice sensations. If you do experience a sharp pain, just come out of the pose. From here, we're going to extend that opposite hand out with the thumb facing down. So the palm faces behind you. You're gonna sweep that hand behind you. And as you do, that top hand, those fingers are gonna kind of grab onto your shirt. As you bend the opposite hand, the palm faces the back. Maybe your fingers come together. It's okay if they don't. Just breathe in and breathe out here. But don't lean forward, lean back and feel a stretch here. Breathe in, breathe out. Again, close your eyes. That feels good for you. Now allow you to come closer into your sensations and it'll feel really good. And connect. Notice where you feel the deepest sensations. Notice where you feel the least sensations. And then sweep your hands back out. Place them on your knees. Roll your shoulders up to your, ears. As you exhale, roll them back and down. And then just take a moment and notice how you feel. Maybe there's more energy that you feel in your upper body or throughout your whole body. And then again, inhale, sweep your arms out. Now remember how I told you to notice which arm was in front? Because the opposite hand now is gonna go in front. You're gonna give yourself a hug. And then let that top arm reach to the side wall as the bottom arm hugs it. Let your shoulders drop away from your ears. Breathe in, breathe out. Again, you can close your eyes, but feel that nice stretch. So if you are doing this in the office or with friends or with family members, just make sure when you sweep over that you're not next to someone too close. Breathe in, breathe out. And then from here, bring your arms in line with your shoulders. Elbows are on top of you. And then you're just going to cross, either wrapping your forearms around and fingers to connect, or your hands go to your shoulders. Breathe in, breathe out. Either way, feel that stretch of your shoulder blades. The belly is pressing into the spine. Lower ribs reach back. Breathe in, breathe out. And then come into your genie pose, letting the hands reach for the opposite elbows, and go ahead. Make three other wishes. Breathe in, breathe out. Reach your hands up over your head. Feel that nice stretch. And then that back hand is just going to release. Those fingers are going to support your lower neck. And you're going to lean back just a little bit with your head. You're keeping a nice straight spine. You feel your tailbone rooting into the earth. Feel that deep stretch. Breathe in, breathe out. And then the top hand's gonna come down to the side. The thumb's gonna point down. The palm will point behind you. And then just sweep that arm down and then around. So either the hands come together or they don't, no big deal. You can reach for your shirt and just grab onto that or scarf if you have at home, you can use that. Breathe in, breathe out, and just feel that deep stretch here. Another breath in, another breath out. And then when you're ready, reach your hands back out. Give yourself a hug. Let your fingers walk behind your shoulder blades and then sweep out again. The opposite hand's gonna go on top. And then just breathe in and breathe out again. Give yourself a hug for a job well done. And then release your hands, place them back down, roll your shoulders up to your ears as your chin floats down. Do this three times. As you breathe in, you reach forward, reach up. As you exhale, you reach back and down. And then reverse. Bring the shoulders back up. As you exhale, bring them forward and down. And this may feel awkward at first because we're so used to rolling our shoulders back, if anything. So just notice how it feels. Not judging it, just almost like a scientist. just observing. And then slowly come to rest. So now, for the most important pose, my favorite, Shavasana. So Shavasana actually means corpse pose, which everyone, when I first heard them, like, ooh. But it's such an important pose for us to do. And we don't nap enough, we don't rest enough. So skip everything else, but come to this pose, Shavasana. And we all need time just to rest, right? So the poses that we just did now will help, the rest time will help us integrate all those poses into our minds. So make it really comfortable. Pretend you're doing it for someone else. So let there be a bolster perhaps. So you're gonna take your feet over the bolster. Definitely use a blanket for your head, but you don't want your head too high up. You want to make sure that it's in line with your spine, but you want to have it so there's a little, there's a lot of comfort, not a little. You deserve a lot of comfort. So from there, just lay down. Make sure your feet are connected to the floor, and then just let your palms face up. This will create more space in your ribs for breathing, and then just lie here. So I'm hoping you have a lot of time for Shavasana today. Perhaps 20 minutes, that would be really good. But whatever you have, just stay here. And feel the crown of your head just releasing. The back of your head is rooting into the floor. Feel your spine sinking down. Feel your spine releasing into the floor. Let the fine muscles around your eyes soften. Create a space between the upper and the lower teeth. And as you exhale, just release a little bit more down into the ground. I want to leave you here to rest. So whenever you need to end it, you end it. So rest here. Let yourself know that you did a great, awesome job today, that you are awesome, and that you are amazing. Let that be the mantra that you say over and over, because it's so true. You are amazing. And I thank you for sharing your time with me. Enjoy your Shavasana.